गुड आफ्टरनून चिल्ड्रन। ऑन दिस कमिंग संडे यू विल हैव टेस्ट ऑफ साइंस, सो आई विल टीच यू द चैप्टर फ्रॉम विच द क्वेश्चंस विल बी आस्क्ड ऑन संडे। नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज कंजर्वेशन ऑफ प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स। Questions will be asked from this chapter. So in this week you have to revise chapter conservation of plants and animals. All of you know India is a large developing country. There are three categories of countries. First one, developed country, second, developing country, and third is underdeveloped country. India belongs to developing country. Okay, India is a developing country and it is well known for its diverse forest ecosystem. So this forest is very important because it is the habitat of many plants and wildlife. We have to read about the conservation of plants and animals. Since forest is the habitat of plants and animals, so we need to protect the forest. We need to preserve the forest. We need to manage the forest, so that we can conserve plants and animals. As you know children, India is a developing country, so many development projects are taking place for urbanization and for industrialization. Urbanization means setting up cities and industrialization means for setting up industries. For making city, for making industries, we are carrying out some development projects like Narmada Valley Project, Tehri Project, etc. And for carrying out these development projects, we are cutting down the trees. We are cutting down trees for some other purposes also. Like we get many raw material from the forest. We get raw material for making paper, pulp, rayon mill, etc. Rayon is a cloth that resembles silk. We also get timber from the forest that is used to make furniture, railway sleepers, etc. Many persons, they procure firewood from the forest which they use as fuel. Sometimes persons get fodder from the forest. Fodder means food of the cattle. That is called fodder. We get building material from the forest. We get many products from the forest, like we can get medicines from the forest, gums, resins, etc. So, for our personal advantage, we are cutting down the trees. Excessive cutting down of tree from the forest is called deforestation. I told you children, forest is the habitat of plants and animals. But due to personal advantage. Human being is cutting down trees excessively. They are cutting down trees for development project to make city, that is urbanization, for industrialization. Human being is cutting down trees. Human being is cutting down of tree to get timber that is used to make furniture and railway sleepers. Many persons use firewood as fuel and they get firewood from the forest. We also use raw material for paper, pulp, rayon mill, etc. that we obtain from forest. So, human being is cutting down trees for personal advantage, and due to this activity there are very bad effect in our climate. Excessive cutting down of tree from the forest is called deforestation. There are two consequences of deforestation. First one, domestic consequence, and second one is global consequence. Domestic in consequence means, first domestic consequence is disrupted river flow. You know, children, due to deforestation, soil erosion takes place. Soil erosion means top layer of the soil is carried away from one place to other place, and due to soil erosion or you can say due to less rainfall, the river changes its path. It is called disrupted river flow. So, as I told you that due to soil erosion and due to decrease in rainfall, there is disruption in the river flow or the path of the river changes. This is domestic consequence of deforestation. Second domestic consequence is flooding, means excess water. All of you know the roots of the trees, they absorb water from the soil, and you have read in the previous class this water is brought from root to leaf through the tissue. Which tissue? Xylem tissue. And this water is a raw material for photosynthesis. All of you know, children. So when we cut down the trees, then the absorption of water from the soil decreases, and due to soil erosion, the soil is carried away from one place to another place, and the soil is deposited in the river bed. So due to two reasons, first reason, due to less absorption of water from the soil, and second reason, due to deposition of soil in the river bed, flooding takes place. Flooding is the result of deforestation. Next consequence of deforestation is drought. Drought means less water. What is the cause of drought? Again, you can say due to deforestation, the carbon dioxide in the atmosphere increases. It leads to global warming. The temperature of the Earth's surface increases and it disturbs the water cycle. And due to disturbance in water cycle, due to less rainfall, drought takes place. So this is second domestic consequence of deforestation. Next domestic consequence of deforestation is plants and wildlife extinction. Extinction means they disappear from the earth. If the forest is cut down, then many plants and many wildlife species, they become extinct. Because you know, forest is the habitat for such plants and wildlife. And what is habitat? Habitat is a place that provides the plant and animal food, shelter and suitable climatic conditions so that these plants and animals can survive, breed and flourish. But due to cutting down of the trees, plants and wildlife, they lose their habitat, they become homeless and they may become extinct. Next consequence is scarcity of forest products. We may get many products from the forest, like we get fruits, gums, resins, etc. So if we cut down the trees from the forest, we can face the scarcity problem of forest products. There will have problem to get the forest product. So there is scarcity of forest product. Next domestic consequence is displacement of forest dweller. Dweller means one who lives in the forest. Many persons, particularly tribes, they live in the forest. And if forest is cut down, they become homeless and they have to shift to some other place. So there is displacement of forest dweller, means they shift to some other place. These are all domestic consequences of deforestation. Next is global consequence of deforestation. First global consequence is climatic change. Due to excessive cutting down of trees, now there is change in the climate. Because you know, children, the trees, they use carbon dioxide for photosynthesis and they release oxygen in the atmosphere. So cutting down of tree may adversely affect our climate. Nowadays, summer has become very hot and winter has become chilled. There is extreme climate and rainfall is also deficient. This is due to deforestation. It is called climatic change. It is global consequence of deforestation. Next global consequence of deforestation is desertification. Desertification means formation of desert. How deserts are formed? You know, due to deforestation, soil erosion takes place. Top layer of soil is carried away from one place to other place. Now, due to soil erosion, the rocky layers are exposed and it leads to the formation of desert. You know, children, in Thar desert, earlier it was a place of very good vegetation, but due to deforestation, it changed into a desert. Okay? So, cutting down of trees can lead to the formation of desert, which is called desertification. Next, global consequence of deforestation is ozone layer depletion. You know, children, ozone layer is present in the stratosphere. There are various layers of atmosphere: troposphere, stratosphere, ionosphere, exosphere. So different functions take place in different layers. As you know, weather formation takes place in troposphere. Then stratosphere is a layer of atmosphere in which jet aeroplanes fly, and ozone layer is present. This ozone layer prevents the ultraviolet rays of the sun to reach the surface of the earth, due to which we are protected from UV rays, ultraviolet rays of the sun. Otherwise, what will happen? If ultraviolet rays will reach on the surface of the earth, the persons will suffer from skin disease, defects in eyes. Okay? Nowadays, children, due to deforestation, the ozone is removed from the stratosphere, and due to depletion in ozone layer, ultraviolet rays are reaching the surface of the earth, and many people have problems of skin. They are having skin diseases, and many of them suffer from defects in eyes, may suffer from cataract and from other diseases. So this is all about global consequence of deforestation. Okay, children, all of you will revise what is the cause of deforestation. Once again, I am telling you, the cause of deforestation is development project which is being carried out due to urbanization and industrialization. Next, to get the timber from the forest. Next, to get the firewood from the forest. To get raw material for paper, pulp, rayon mill, etc. To get medicine. To get fodder. For all these purposes, forest is being cut down. Excessive cutting down of tree from the forest is called deforestation. Deforestation has two consequences: domestic consequence and global consequence. Domestic consequence: disrupted river flow, flooding, drought, extinction of plants and wildlife, displacement of forest dweller, and scarcity of forest products. These are the domestic consequences of deforestation. And global consequence of deforestation is climatic change. Next, desertification. And last point is ozone layer depletion. So all of you will revise and you will learn keywords related to these two topics. Okay, children? So with this, your topic is complete. Thank you.